Hi everyone, this is Ross from ggCircuit, and today I'm going to be covering the Games and Apps menu within the Web Administrator, showing you how to enable games and create a license management solution for your venue. So if we head over to the Settings button in the navbar and go to Client Configuration, which is where you'll find the settings for your gaming PCs, and we go into the Games/Apps. From here, we're going to see a big list of all the available games in our system, games and apps, I should say. So currently there are 3,631, but as more games and apps get released, then we're continually adding to this number. So with the filters at top, for my particular venue, I can see all of the games that I've enabled. I can see all the games and apps that I haven't enabled. I can also see the top 100 games in our network if you want to quickly find popular games. And we can also see the newly added games. And these are games that have been added to the system recently. So if you're looking for ideas on which games to add to your system, then this might be a button to click as well. Now, the main purpose for this functionality on the admin is to select which game tiles will be visible in the ggLeap client for your gamers. So if Minecraft is a game that you think will be popular, your gamers will like it, then you want to make sure that that's enabled in the client. And you also want to make sure that the files are installed. So enabling the games doesn't automatically install the games. The games will need to be installed. Now, we can do that as part of our managed services. We have a lot of customers who have us maintain their games to make sure that they're always installed correctly and always maintained and patched on a daily basis. So we can handle all of that, but it's also something that you can do yourself. The important thing to note here is that the games that you do enable for your venue, the files need to be on the PCs for those games to work. So if we click on just a couple of these to give an example. So if we look at the top 100 games, for example, this shows for me a list of games, some of which are enabled, and you can see that by the toggle in the top left, as well as the fact that they have color, and also lots of games that I haven't enabled. So from here, I can either enable a game like Overwatch, and doing that will simply mean that the next time the PC is rebooted, Overwatch will become an option. However, it's important that the Overwatch settings are correct. Now, we do configure all of these games on your behalf on a global level so that we have defaults for all of these games with the known parameters. So you shouldn't have to change too much, but if you have some custom settings, then you will need to make some changes. So for example, for Overwatch, it is a game rather than a program or a setting. The age rating is something that you can set if you want certain games to have a minimum age restriction. And if a gamer is aged under this number, then the game simply will not show for that user. We can also select a number of tags on a per game basis. This makes it easier for gamers to find particular games or genres that they like in the client. And you can also add a link to the website if you want gamers to find that website as well. In addition, each game, usually nowadays, has a corresponding launcher. So that can be Battle.net. There's a whole bunch of other ones as well these days. Steam, Origin, Epic. There's quite a lot of them. We support all of these launchers in terms of being able to launch the game, but also we support them in terms of an auto login, which is part of our automatic license system. So below here, you'll see there is a checkbox for that. The automatic license system allows you to create a bunch of login and passwords for any individual game, and then your gamers can automatically log themselves into the game using those credentials without actually ever being able to see those credentials. So it's a quick way for gamers or groups of gamers to come in and play a game without you having to worry about creating accounts and setting up passwords and doing 2FA and all of the things that can come along with getting especially a young group of gamers into a game as quickly as possible. So the automatic license system allows you to configure everything beforehand so that it's easy for your gamers to just get into games. So we'll cover the automatic license system in a few minutes, but basically if we wanted to make Overwatch be a game that made use of that facility, we would check this box. And because the license management system can be used across multiple venues, so if you do have multiple venues, you can have a single license pool. So you can have a single place where your licenses exist, and each of your gamers at a PC in any of your venues can pull from that central license pool. However, if you don't want to use that central license pool for this particular game, then actually you would check this box if you wanted to run things separately. Okay, so let's also have a look at Fall Guys as another example. So this is a game that I have enabled. It will appear in ggLeap Client. And this game does have multiple launchers, so we want to be able to support two. So for example, if somebody wants to play their own account, then it's ideal to be able to offer both options to the gamer. So we can facilitate that just by adding both of those launchers in there. We can also facilitate auto login to either Epic or Steam as well. Okay, so I think we've got the basics of being able to enable games and configure them. Let's head over to the license management section, and that's found in the center config licenses section of the web admin. Now, as you can see, I've already got five licenses set up here, or five keys as we call them. So there are five keys that have been created, with each with their individual usernames and passwords. As you can see, these are test details, but they use Steam, and there are five available. And there are zero obviously in use. But if a gamer was to click the button in the ggLeap client to borrow one of these accounts, then we would see the PC number that's using that account. And then this particular license would not be available for anyone else to use until this particular gamer has finished playing with that license on this game. So if we wanted to create a brand new license pool, let's say for example, we want to do Fall Guys, then we would select Fall Guys from here, either Steam or Epic. Let's go for Epic in this case. And now we've created a pool. We just need to add licenses. So from here, we can choose that this is an Epic. And usually we just call these licenses in order. And this is an example of username and password for Epic. So we would needed to have already created these accounts with Epic, and then we can add more. Okay, and that's it. It's as simple as that. So now I've created two available licenses. So I have two Epic accounts. I've popped in the username and password for both of those. And now if a gamer presses the button on Fall Guys to automatically log into the game, it will take a key from this pool, letting the gamer easily play that game. And just to show how that looks in the ggLeap client. So if we go to games, and we have a look at a game that does have the license management enabled. You'll see that there are two buttons that the user can press. They can either log in with their own account if they own one, or they can click the just play, which will prompt the user to be able to borrow one of the available licenses. And if they played this game before and have borrowed a license previously, clicking this button will automatically choose the same license as was used last time in case they want to continue a saved game. Otherwise, if we go to a game that doesn't have a license management set up, then there is only the option to log in with Epic Games, because that is not the only option. Okay, so that's the end of this video, which was a quick overview of the games, apps, and license management. If you have any questions or suggestions or any feedback, please leave it in the comments below, and I'll see you next time. Thanks.